Hello guys, a very good afternoon. This is Vinay Bhatt here, and today I'm going to give you a small presentation on one of the interprocess communication technique, that is shared memory. So quickly let us see what do you mean by shared memory. Shared memory is a memory which is shared between two or more processes. Shared memory is also an efficient means of passing data between programs. One program will create a memory portion which other processes, if it is permitted, can access it. So the below figure demonstrates that two processes can communicate each other using a common piece of memory which is shared across two processes. So this is what is the meaning of shared memory. Now the next question is, why do we need to share the memory? This is because each process has its own address space, and if any process wants to communicate with some information from its own address space to the other processes, then it is only possible with IPC technique. As we are already aware, communication can be between related or unrelated processes. Usually, interrelated process communication is performed using pipes. Unrelated processes communication can be performed using named pipes or through popular IPC techniques of shared memory and message queue. So below is a diagram which depicts that process 1 and process 2 is communicating using a small piece of shared memory. Next, let us see how different is shared memory from the other IPCs. The problem with pipes, FIFO and message queue is that for two processes to exchange information, the information has to go through the kernel. That is, server reads the input from the input file. Server writes this data in a message using either a FIFO, pipe or message queue. Then the client reads the data from the IPC channel, again requiring the data to be copied from the kernel's IPC buffer to the client's buffer. Finally, the data is copied from the client's buffer. So this tells that a total of 4 copies of data are required, that is 2 reading operation and 2 writing operation. But in shared memory, this provides a way by letting 2 or more processes that share a memory segment. With shared memory, the data is only copied twice. That is from input file into the shared memory and from shared memory to the output file. Please remember that when write access is allowed for more than one processes, we can make use of an outside protocol or a mechanism such as a semaphore that can be used to prevent inconsistencies and collision as shown in the below program. So below diagram states that there are two processes, writer and reader, which is going to communicate using a small piece of common memory which is being shared across the two processes. So server waits if any other processes is accessing this memory and waits until the reader processes completes it. Once the reader process completes, it is going to signal the writer processes. Then the writer processes will copy the data from the input device to the shared memory, and then it signals the reader process saying that it has completed its writing operation. Then the reader processes will read the information being written into the shared memory from the writer processes, and then again it signals that it has completed its reading operation to the writer process, and this process continues so that only a single process is being accessing a shared memory at a time. So this is how the two processes communicate using semaphore in order to have a process synchronization. Next one is the properties of shared memory. So the properties of shared memory will be explained in terms of advantages and disadvantages. The advantages of shared memory are, it is faster, then it doesn't require extra kernel buffer, and it is safe. The disadvantages is that data can be either read or written only, that is, append is not possible. And the another disadvantage is a race condition, which is possible, so locking is required in shared memory. Next, we will see what are the different system calls which are used in shared memory. The very first system call is a shared memory get, which is used to obtain access to a shared memory segment. The second system call is a shared memory attach, which is used to attach shared memory segments. Third system call is a shared memory detach, which is used to detach shared memory segment. And the fourth system call is a shared memory control, which is used to alter the permission and other characteristics of a shared memory segment. All these system calls are used for different stages of shared memory. That is, to use the shared memory, as the diagram reveals, that first of all, one process should allocate the segment. Then after allocating, each process which desires to access the segment should attach with the segment. After accessing the segment, each process should detach it. And it is also necessary to allocate the segment without fail. So all these four stages are being explained in the diagram. Note that only one process can access the memory at a time, and this is done using semaphore for process synchronization to maintain consistency, and this has been discussed previously. Now let us see the very first allocation, the very first stage, that is allocation. So guys, what do you mean by allocation? Allocation is nothing but a process that allocates a shared memory using one of the system called, say, shared memory get function. The diagram says that process should first of all allocate a shared memory before accessing it. And the system call which we use for allocating is shared memory get, which takes three different parameters. The parameters are a key, which is an access value associated with the segment. We should take care of one of the problem which may arise, that is, if another processes also choose the same fixed key, then what should we do? The solution to this problem is, you can either use a special constant, say IPC private has one of its key value, which would guarantee that there would be a creation of new memory segment. The second parameter is a argument, size argument, which indicates the number of bytes of the requested shared memory segment. Third parameter is a shared memory flag argument, which specifies the initial access permission and creation of control flags. The possible flag values are IPC create, which indicates that a new segment should be created. The second flag value may be IPC axel. This is always used with IPC create. It causes the shared memory to fail if its key value already exists. The third flag value is a mode flag, which is a 9-bit indicating the permission granted to owner, group and others to access the segment. Upon successful completion, shared memory segment returns an identifier for the shared memory and -1 on error. So this is how the allocation process takes place. Next stage is an attachment. So what happens in attachment? When the shared memory segment is created, it could not be accessed by any process. So to enable the access, it must be attached to the address space of a process. And this can be done with the help of one of the system called, say, shared memory attach function. And this is been shown in the below diagram. Once the process finishes its allocation, the next process is an attachment. And this can be done using shared memory attach system call, which takes a three different parameter. The parameters are shared memory identifier, which is returned by the shared memory get system call. Second parameter is the address at which the segment is to be attached to the current process. This can be null pointer, so that there comes an option for the system that can choose the address at which the memory is available. The third parameter is the flag value. And there are two possible flag values. They are SHM which means shared memory RND, that controls the address at which the segment is attached. And the second flag value is a shared memory read-only that makes the attachment read-only. And similarly, if the calls succeed, it will return the address of the attached shared memory, shared segment, and minus one on error. So this is what happens in the detachment process. Sorry, in the attachment process. The next stage is the detachment stage, but keep in mind that there is one more stage between attachment and detachment, which I have not discussed yet. Because once the attachment is completed, the purpose of attachment is the process has to access the shared memory, and the accessing can be done by using either read operation or write operation. And once the read or write operation is completed successfully, the process has to get itself detached from the memory. And this can be done by using another system called, say, shared memory detach function, which will detach the shared memory from the parent processes. Its syntax says that it takes only one parameter, and that parameter is the pointer to the address which is being returned by the shared memory get as the parameter. And this system call again on success, it returns 0 and minus 1 on error. The next stage is a controlling and deallocation stage, which is being done using another system called, say, shared memory control function, which will return the information about a shared memory segment. And remember that using shared memory control function, a shared memory can also be modified by the user. The syntax of shared memory control function is shown here. It takes three different parameters. The first parameter is the shared memory identifier returned by the shared memory get system call. Second parameter is the command argument, which may take one of the following value. The possible or available values are IPC stat, which returns the status information contained in the control structure, and place it in the buffer pointed to by buf. The process must have read permission on the segment to perform this command. The second value can be IPC set, which sets the effective user and group identification and access permission. The process must have an effective ID of owner or creator or super user to perform this command. The third value is IPC RMID, which will delete the shared memory segment. Third parameter for the shared memory control system call is a buffer, which is a pointer to the structure of type struct shared memory ID DS, which is a user defined structure, and that is being defined in shared memory.h, containing the modes and permission for the shared memory. So once the detachment is completed, it is the responsibility of the process to get deallocated from the memory explicitly. So overall, we have seen the five different stages in the process of shared memory. What are those five different stages? The very first stage is a allocation process. The second stage is a attachment process. The third stage is a accessing of shared memory. Fourth stage is a detachment process. And fifth stage is a deallocation process. So below sequence diagram once again explains what are the different stages of a shared memory. The sequence diagram has two processes. One is writer and the another one is a reader, and a common shared memory which is being shared across two processes. So first of all, the writer process will create the memory using shared memory get, and on success, this shared memory get return system call returns the identifier to the shared memory. Meanwhile, once the shared memory is being created, the reader process keeps checking whether the data is available or not. Then the writer process, once the allocation is completed, it has to get itself attached with the shared memory using another system called, say, shared memory attach, which provides other processes provided no other processes is attached with the memory. So this says that it takes care of that only one process is being attached with the shared memory at a time. on success of attachment, then the writer will access the shared memory in terms of writing data in the memory. Meanwhile, on the other side, the reader process will keep checking whether the data is available in the shared memory or not. Once the writer process completes, then it gets itself detached from the shared memory using another system called a shared memory detach. And once the detachment is completed, it will signal the reader process about its completion, so that immediately the signal is been sent to the reader process. The reader process will check whether the data is available or not. Once the data is available, reader process is going to get itself attached with the memory so that it can read the data and print it. Once the reading process is completed, the reader process will signal the writer process about its completion. Meanwhile, till then, the writer process will wait for the reader to complete. Once the signal is been received by the writer processes, it understands that the reader process has completed its operation. So the next duty of the writer process is to check whether if any other processes is accessing the shared memory or not. If not, the memory has to be deallocated using another system called say shared memory control. So guys, this is how the overall stages of shared memory takes place between two different processes. So next part is the implementation of shared memory. So for which I have defined a problem statement which says that write two programs, say shared memory 1.c and shared memory 2.c, that will communicate string message via shared memory. Data, which is a message string, will be exchanged via memory and notify each process when operations such as memory gets loaded and memory read have been performed. So for the problem statement given above, we are going to develop two programs here that illustrate the passing of a simple piece of memory, that is a string, between the processes if running simultaneously. So the two programs are shared memory 1.c, which acts like a server that attaches itself to the created shared memory portion and uses the string, and another process acts like a client or a reader process or a writer process. Like what I mean to say is these two processes or these two programs act like writer and reader processes. So one program will create the string, create the memory and create the string so that it writes the string into the memory, and the another processes is going to read the written string and prints it. So by looking at the program, we understand that shared memory 2.c simply creates the string from the user input and shared memory portion, and shared memory 1.c attaches itself to the created shared memory portion and uses the string. So it states that shared memory 2.c acts like a server program, like writer program, and shared memory 1.c acts like a client program or a reader program, which reads the string from the shared memory. So below is the code. So you can see here that there are various header file which is been included, and one of the main header file which we need to include here is shm.h, which contains a control structure that contains information about mode and access permission. Then we have a user defined structure which acts like a shared memory across two processes, and the contents of the structure is a variable data available, which indicates the data is available or not. And the second variable is a message, which is a character array to hold the input string. Then comes the main function. So as I have already discussed the different stages of shared memory, this is being shown by implementing. First stage is a allocation of shared memory, and this is being done using shared memory get function. On failure, this shared memory get function is going to return -1, and the validation is being done here. If the shared memory get function fails, it has to prompt a message to the user saying that allocation has been failed. Then comes the attachment of segment, which is being done using a system called say shared memory attach. If this is success, then user gets a message saying that memory has been attached at so and so addresses. If not, user will again get a message saying that the attachment process has got failed. Now next part is accessing part, that is process is performing write operation. So it has to check whether any other processes is running or not on the shared memory. While other process is still reading it, then it waits for the other process to complete its task. If not, server will create the string by asking the user an input, and that string is being read from the standard input device and stores it in a buffer. The same string message is being written into the character array message as shown here. Then the next part is to make the variable data available as true, which indicates the other process that the data is available. The process of reading input from the user is terminated by another string, say end, which is used to terminate the loop. And once the input is being stopped, we have to say that the writer process has to stop by setting the value as false. Then the writer process has to get itself detached from the memory segment, and this is being done by shared memory detach. And if it fails, the user will get a message saying that detachment process has been failed. So this is how the writer process is going to work. Once the writer process finishes, we are now interested about the implementation detail of the reader process. So the reader process implementation almost has the same piece of code which is been already discussed in the writer process. It has a header file, say shared memory.h. Then it is going to make use of the same piece of structure which acts like a shared memory. And the contents are once again data available and a message which is going to hold the input string. Then in the main function, the reader process once again it has to get itself allocated, like it has to allocate the shared memory with the same key values so that it acts like a same memory that gets shared across the reader process. And this is being done using one of the system calls, say shared memory get, using the same key value 1, 2, 3, 4. If on success, it is going to return an identifier, and on failure, it is going to prompt a message to the user saying that the allocation process has been failed. The next part is the attachment process, which is being done using shared memory attach function. Then once the attachment is success, user gets a message saying that reader process has got attached at so and so addresses. Now the next part is to check whether the data is available or not. And reader process once again checks whether any other processes is running or not. If so, it has to wait for the other process to complete. Now, this part says that if data is available, or if data is available which is set to true, indicates data is available to read. So it is going to read the data and prints the message which is being written by the writer process. Once the reading is completed, it has to make the data available as false, indicating that it has finished its reading operation. And it has to make the process running as false. Once the reading is completed, or once the access is completed, The reader process will get itself detached from the shared memory using the same system call, say shared memory detach. And finally, it checks whether any other process is being using the shared memory or not. If not, it is going to deallocate the overall shared memory by using shared memory control function. So the output says that client program is going to write whatever the writer program has written into the memory. That is, you can see here that since I have said that shared memory 2.c acts like a writer process, it asks the input from the user, and once the input is been given by the user, the reader process will read the data which is being written and displays it. Once the reader process completes its first part of the reading operation, the next part is the writer process once again asks the input from the user. The same input again is being printed by the reader process. So this is how the communication takes place between the two processes, that is writer and reader, using a common piece of memory, say shared memory. So guys, I hope this clears your understanding, or this improves your understanding on shared memory. And below are the references which I have used to prepare my presentation. Thank you.